एवरीवन, दिस इज शिवानी सिंह फ्रॉम संस्कार ग्लोबल स्कूल. टुडे वी आर हियर टू स्टडी द थीम फोर, दैट इज सेंट्रल इस्लामिक लैंड्स इन हिस्ट्री, क्लास 11th. नाउ वी विल सी द राइज ऑफ इस्लाम इन थ्री फेजेस, बेसिकली द फेथ, कम्युनिटी एंड द पॉलिटिक्स. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फेथ. द अरब्स वर पॉलीथीस्टिक इन नेचर, दैट मीन्स दे यूज टू वर्शिप सो मेनी रिलीजन्स एट अ टाइम, एंड दे वर ऑल्सो द फॉलोअर्स ऑफ द आइडल वर्शिप, एंड दे वर डिवाइडेड इन टू कबीलाज, एंड ईच कबीला हैड ओन गॉड्स एंड गॉडेसेस. दे ऑल्सो वर्शिप्ड अ आइडल विच वॉज नोन एज सनम, एंड दे वर्शिप देम इन द मस्जिद्स विच वर द श्राइन्स. They were familiar with the supreme notion of one God, that is Allah. They were deeply attached with the idols and the shrines also. Now we will discuss about Prophet Muhammad. He was born in Makkah in 570. In 612 to 632, Prophet Muhammad preached worship of single God, that is Allah, and he was against the idol worship. And also in the membership of single community of believers, which were known as Ummah, the followers of Prophet Muhammad were known as Ummah, the Muslims we see today. Okay, this was the origin of Islam, this was the advent of Islam. Around 612, he declared himself as messenger of God, that is known as Rasul. Now, who had been commanded to preach that Allah alone should be worshipped, no other God should be worshipped. In 622, Prophet Muhammad was forced to migrate with his followers to Medina. Why? Because Arabian people were worshipping the idols and he was against it. So Arabian people found him as a threat to their religion. So he was forced out with his followers. Muhammad's journey from Makkah to Medina is known as Hijr or Hajj. It was turning point in the history of Islam. Why? Because it was the arrival. His arrival in Medina marked the beginning of the Muslim calendar, that is also known as the Hijri Samvat. Okay, after that, Muslim population less than 10% in the Umayyad, a prosperous dynasty was there, and Prophet Muhammad was Quraysh. That Qurayshi caste we hear today, he was also belonging to the Quraysh tribes. Now we will talk about the community. Prophet Muhammad found a set of believers which were known as Ummah, we have discussed earlier. Muhammad's message particularly appealed to those Makkans who felt deprived of the gains from the trade and religion. Those who were under the pressure of Arabian culture, they were now ready to follow a new kind of religion. Those who accepted the doctrine were called as Muslims. They were promised salvation on the day of judgment, that was known as Qiyamah, that we called Qiyamah today, and a share of the resources when they were living on the earth. Okay. Now the Muslims faced opposition from Makkans and they were forced to leave that place. Now we will talk about the polity. After the death of Muhammad in 632 AD, there was a instability in political authority. Why? Because he had no son and there was no established successor, no declared successor was there. And this created opportunities for innovation but also caused deep division among the Muslims. Some of the Muslims wanted Abu Bakr to be the next caliph and some of the other section wanted Ali to be the next caliph. Now, what was the biggest innovation at that time after the death of Prophet Muhammad? It was creation of substitution of the caliphates. Leaders of the community, that is Amir al-Mu'min, became the deputy caliph of the Prophet. He does not become the caliph, he became the deputy of the caliph. What were the objects of the caliphs? There were twin objectives. First was to control over the tribes that were constituting the Ummah, that were the believers, and to raise the resources for the state, and their main duties were to safeguard and spread Islam. Now we will talk about modern Islam. In 21st century, there are 1 billion Muslims living in all parts of the world, and they are citizens of different language, different attire, they wear different dresses, they wear different languages, they speak, but they follow the Islam religion. Now we will talk about the early Islam. United by its observance of the Sharia. Sharia is a law governing the Muslims. It was defining its religious identity, and the principle of equality were there. There was no caste system in the Muslims. They were all the children of Allah. Islam strongly opposed the idol worship and the Arab people were worshipping the idols. The five pillars of Islam you must have heard earlier also, that is reciting kalma, that are the holy chants, namaz, offering prayers for the five times. Roza was there, that was observed in the month of Ramzan, and zakat was there, that was known as the alms tax, and the hajj are the five pillars. Even tribes which were outside Mecca, they used to consider Kaaba as holy, and idols there were worshipped in the shrines, making annual pilgrimage that is known as Hajj. You have already heard that. Social scenario before Prophet Muhammad, we will discuss. Before Prophet Muhammad, that means before the advent of Islam, the people of people of Arab were basically known as Jahiliya. It was an Islamic concept where Arabia was a backward community. People were suffering an age of ignorance over there. The Jahiliya age was the age of the tribes. So basically we will see that Arabia before the advent of the Islam was economically, politically and religiously backward. There was a prominent tribe which was known as Bedouins. They were the nomadic peoples and they moved from one place to another in the search of green grasses. An institution of slavery were also there. The tribes were intelligent.